नमस्कार उन पूर्व जन्मों में किए गए संचित पापों में से कुछ पाप जिनका फल भोगना इस जन्म में है अथवा पूर्व जन्म में जो हम लोगों ने पाप किए हैं, पापों का फल वर्तमान जन्म में भोग करना पड़ता है। अभी जो हम भोग कर रहे हैं सुख और दुख, ये प्रारब्ध पाप अप्रारब्ध अनेक जन्मों में किए हुए पाप जो संचित हैं, जिनका भोग अभी आरंभ नहीं हुआ है, उनको अप्रारब्ध या सूक्ष्म पाप जो पाप का बीज वासना पाप करने की वासना जिसको जो आने वाले जन्मों में जिनका फल भोगना है उनको रूप पाप और बीज पाप वासना में हमने मन ही मन ने जो संकल्प किया इस आदमी को मार डाले, यहां पर हम व्यभिचार करें, यहां पर हम बुरा कर्म करेंगे। पहले मन में आती है वासना, तब कर्म में परिणत होता। यही प्रारब्ध कर्म की पृष्ठभूमि है, पहले वासना और प्रथम कर्म में उसको लगते हैं पाप का। भक्ति जब प्रारंभ में आरंभ होती है तो का पाप कर्म करने की वासना भी नष्ट हो जाती है। सब वासना के आकार में चिंतन जो गुप्त रूप से रहते, ये पाप करने की वासना पिता की पिता अंदर में रहती है और यथा समय भगवान की इच्छा से ये प्रारब्ध हो करके फलों का भोग कराते हैं। परतत्व से विमुख परिमुख जी है, अविद्या से वासना की सृष्टि हो, अविद्या के बदलाया अनित्य सुखों को नित्य समझना, अपवित्र को पवित्र समझना, दुख को सुख समझना और देह के पुत्र परिवार में को नित्य समझना, ये है अविद्या। तो ये अविद्या से वासना की सृष्टि होती है। वासनाओं को भोग करने के लिए देव मनुष्य तिरजक उन वासनाओं को भोग करने के लिए मनुष्य देवता पशु पक्षी पेड़ पौधे पर्वत ये जन्म योनियों में मनुष्य देही सबके लिए कर्म है। वृक्ष इत्यादि योनि देवता योनि पेड़ पौधे ये कर्म योनि नहीं है, केवल फल भोग करते हैं। कुत्ता है किसी को काट लिया, उसका कर्म नहीं बनेगा, उसका फल नहीं भोगना पड़ेगा, किंतु कुत्ते को जो मारेगा उसका फल भोग करना पड़ेगा। यहां तक कि जो मच्छर मारेगा, मच्छर काटता है उसका कर्म फल नहीं होगा, और जो मच्छर को मारता है उसका कर्म फल नहीं होगा। यही तो कर्म बनता है। हमारे गोस्वामी लोग क्या कर रहे हैं, इसलिए मच्छर का भी बना के मच्छर काटे नहीं। वो जाने पर भी उसको निकाल दो बाहर।
All types of disturbance will be burned to ashes. That klesh, as we discussed last night, is of five different types. Avidya, asmita, raag, dvesh, and avinivesh. No need to go through that again. Also, you should know there are four levels of karma. Parabdha, aparabdha, root, bij, kud. Parabdha karma means the previous pious and sinful activities that we have performed in our millions of previous lives, which is now manifesting in the form of material happiness or misery, this is called parabdha karma. Aparadha means in our previous life, the pious and sinful activities we have performed, which we have not yet tasted, but we will taste in the future, that is called aparadha karma. Then there is bij, root, or kud. This means like seed. Our previous activities is like a platform in which these seeds of vasana or desire are resting. And they sprout within the mind. That sprout is called kud. For example, if I am thinking, I will kill him, he is my enemy. I will perform this illicit activity, I will steal, I will do this good activity. These are all vasanas or tendencies or desires. These are coming from our parabdha karma and these are called bij. And it is these desires which are taking us through the endless cycle of birth and death. Therefore these vasanas or material desires are hidden in the mind in the form of a seed. And when the proper time comes by the desire of Bhagavan, then it sprouts in our mind and we act upon it. Therefore, these vasanas, or these material desires or seeds, they are springing from the first type of klesh called avidya, or ignorance. Yesterday we heard, avidya means to misunderstanding, to consider that which is eternal to be temporary, to consider that which is a source of misery to be a source of happiness, this is avidya. And from this avidya, all these vasanas or material desires are born. To enjoy these material desires, which are in the heart in the seed form, we are taking birth again and again and again. One thing we should understand, only the human form of life is called karma yoni. Means only the human form of life it's possible to create karma. But all the other species, including the demigods, demons, the trees, animals, and insects, these are called phalabhogi yoni. Means they are simply getting the result of their karma. They cannot make any new karma. Only a human being can make that. For example, if a dog bites me, that dog is experiencing no karma. But if I bite the dog or kill him, then I am making karma for myself. If a mosquito comes, he has not making any karma. He is simply acting on his karma, and I squish him, then I am making karma for myself. Puchapad Maharaj gave the argument. Shastra says there are six types of persons, killing them is no harm. Krishna himself said, if a mosquito comes, we kill him. This is one type of aggressor. Killing him is not a sin.
What do you do?
Don't ask me. Then Gurudev said, this, what our Goswamis have done, the way they have acted, we should act like that. And it's such a big problem, you can put up your mosquito net. So, these five types of avidya, these are all destroyed both by Raga Ruga and by Vani Bhakti. Also, Kleshakti Subhara, in the stage of Sadhana Bhakti, all good qualities which are favorable for devotion appear automatically in the heart by the influence of Bhakti Devi. All this Kleshakti Subhara is experienced in the stage of Sadhana Bhakti. Thus, we can understand within ourselves how much we have developed through Sadhana Bhakti. If we are still experiencing material happiness and misery, that means these five types of klesh or disturbance are still there. That means we are still experiencing our karma. Therefore, we have not completely developed our Sarvabhakti. Also, you should know there are thousands and thousands of gradations or levels of this Kleshakti, or destruction of disturbances. Now we cannot understand completely what stage we are in. An example, someone who is eating and their stomach is completely full. When they're completely full, only they can understand, I'm completely full. When their stomach is not completely full, then they cannot completely understand what it means to have a completely full stomach. So, all of us have this to various degrees. We have experience of happiness or distress. We have varieties of material desires. It depends upon our sincerity, how much these will be destroyed. So, Guru said, I know that even though we have come from Parikram and there is Parikata day and night, still so many people are coming making boyfriends and girlfriends. Guru says, I know who they are, I know their names. If they continue like this and it comes to me, I will throw them out of the Parikram and I'll make sure they'll never come for any future Parikram. Go on, Premananda.
Thank you.
अहंकार के ग्रंथि को जो कर्मों से गठित है उसको छिन्न भिन्न कर डालते हैं। जिस प्रकार इंद्रियों का प्रत्याहार करके भी निर्विशेषवादी सन्यासी लोग वैसा नहीं कर पाते। नाम ध्येय
सत्य साथ
परम सत्य कृष्ण हैं, त्रि सत्य हैं, सत्यों के मूल हैं, इसलिए कृष्ण का जो भजन करता है वो सत्य सार है। नहीं तो कोई भी उनमें दोष नहीं, वतन बड़े उदार मृदु व्यवहार करते हैं, मधुर बातें बोलते हैं, सूची सब समय पवित्र अंदर और बाहर सब समय पवित्र रहते हैं। अकिंचन कृष्ण भक्ति के अतिरिक्त तो उनका कुछ भी साथ नहीं, ऐसे रूप सनातन इत्यादि ऐसे कुछ रखते ही नहीं। सर्व उपकार समस्त लोगों का उपकार करते हैं, कभी किसी की निंदा इत्यादि पर चर्चा नहीं करते। शाम कृष्ण ही प्रसन्न, कृष्ण के शरणागत होते हैं। अकाम कोई कामना वासना नहीं होती, अनिल स्थिर विदित सर्वगुण सर्वगुणों को विजय करने वाले, अनिल अपनी प्रशंसा इत्यादि की इच्छा नहीं होती, और मधुर भाषी मानव अमारी गंभीर करुण मित्र कवि दक्ष हो। इसमें कृष्ण ही का शरण मुख है, कृष्ण का शरण यदि नहीं लेते तो और सब पूर्ण रहने पर भी उसका कोई मतलब नहीं। और कृष्ण का कृष्ण के शरणागत है इसलिए इनमें शरीर मायावादियों में भी सारे ये गुण हो सकते हैं किंतु कृष्ण ही का शरण नहीं होता, इसलिए उनका ये सब होना बेकार का।
So it's mentioned that Srimad Bhagavatam, and Kapila Deva is saying, those devotees who engage themselves in sadhu bhajan, they can control their mind and senses in a way which is not possible even for the topmost of the impersonalist sannyasi. Again, he said, in Namadeya Shavanam Kidana, Yedmana, etc. He said here, just by hearing the name and performing Kirtan of the name, then even a person in the lowest section of society who eats the flesh of dogs becomes equal to a Brahman who performs the Soma Yajna sacrifice, so much they become pure. If someone becomes so pure just hearing and chanting the name, then what to speak of the purity of the Vaishnava who has had the direct vision of the Lord? So, by this sadhana bhakti, all the five types of klesh, as well as the four levels of pap, of karma, such as paramda, aparamda, kut, and bij, are all destroyed. But sometimes we see in the topmost devotees, like Draupadi, they have so much suffering. And we should understand this suffering is not the result of their previous activities. For example, when Sita was kidnapped by Ravan, she underwent so much unhappiness. But this is not karma, this is the lila of Sri Ramchandra. Therefore, sometimes Krishna may seem fit to give a Vaishnava some unhappiness, but we should understand this is not a result of their previous sinful activities, rather this is Bhagavan's mercy upon them to keep them very humble. Therefore Krishna Krishna Bhakti Guru Sakare Sanchari. Krishna empowers the devotee with all of his own good qualities. Tajadaki Vaishnava Yamaharitu Tajari Nishchayatari Paramanandasa. If we see unhappiness in the Vaishnava, we should understand that this is actually one great form of mercy. And this is not their karma, this is direct mercy of the Lord Himself. Therefore, the Vaishnava is equipped with all 26 good qualities. They are always grateful, merciful. They never act in a way to seek revenge. Like Yudhisthira, so much he was tortured by Duryodhana But he never did anything to try to fight back. Yudhisthira could not leave his own good nature, and Duryodhana could not give up his nature. A Vaishnava is Satyasar, means they accept the essence of everything, the absolute truth, Sri Krishna, who is true in Trisatya, in part the three phases of time, past, present, and future. Or a Vaishnava is always truthful. A Vaishnava is Nirdosh. A Vaishnava has no fault, and they never see the faults in others. A Vaishnava is very broad-minded. They're very sweet-speaking. They're very pure, internally and externally. They are akinchan, meaning they have nothing except Haribhakti, like Sivarupa and Sanatana Goswami. They're sarvapakaraka. They always act for the benefit of others. They never blaspheme others. They are always peaceful. Krishnoika Sadhanam. They are completely surrendered only to Sri Krishna. They are steer, fixed, anear. No desire for their own position or sense gratification. They are gambhir, very grave, mona, silent, daksha, expert, mani, amani. They always give respect to others, but never demand respect for themselves. So all these qualities are empowered in the heart of the devotee in who has surrendered and taken the shelter of Bhakti Devi. But we should understand of all these 26 qualities, one is the main, or Angi, that is Krishna Ekasadhanam. The main quality of a Vaishnava is he is exclusively surrendered to Sri Krishna. If the other 25 qualities are there, but the quality of not being surrendered to Krishna is not there, then the other 25 qualities have no value at all. For example, we can see the Mayavadis, they possess all 25 qualities, but they have no surrender to Krishna, therefore it is completely useless.